These are complex fractions, and what we want to do is turn them into one fraction, not fractions within a fraction. So we want to basically get rid of the complex. And the way we do that is you look for the longer line. There's always going to be this little longer line. That right there is the division. And I like to double line it just to give us a nice clean, tell us where it is. So what that means is we have x over x plus 7. And that's being divided by 5 over x plus 5. And then whenever we're dividing a fraction, we're supposed to flip it. And there we go. So what we get is x plus 5 over 5, x plus 7. And now we have one fraction. And the reason I'm not distributing it is because we want something that might cancel or be usable later. You can distribute if you want, and you'd have x squared plus 5x over 5x plus 35. They would both be good answers. All right, try number 2 for me. Hit pause and give it a shot. And that's what you should have. So sometimes these fractions reduce and sometimes they don't. So like I said before, you can write it in its factored form or in its distributed form. Both are good answers. All right, this one's a little different now. So if you notice, it's a complex fraction, but it's got other things added to it. And what we could do is add the tops to make it look like one fraction and add the bottom or subtract the bottoms to make it look like one fraction. But there's a trick. Here's the trick. So you put a parenthesis here, and with fractions, you're allowed to multiply top and bottom. And what we're going to choose is to multiply by the LCD. So our LCD here would be, for every single fraction that's in this problem, is just A. So if we multiply the top by A and the bottom by A, what it's going to do is cancel all these little fractions that we have inside, making it no longer complex. All right, but here's what I like to do. I'm going to put it in a different color. Since we're going to distribute, since we have two terms on top, two terms on the bottom, I'm going to put another A over here just so that we know for just location's sake. We're not actually multiplying by an A to both sides. It's just A top and bottom. And that way we're allowed to reduce it, and that would give us 1 plus 1 times A. And then over here we can cancel. That leaves us with 1 minus 1A. And there's our answer. It's nice and clean, huh? Nice and quick. All right, so that's what we're going to be using when you see multiple terms in there. All right, so let's try one more. We have an LCD of, we have 4 and 8, so that would be 8, and then also an X. So you put a parenthesis top, parenthesis bottom, and you write 8X. You also have to multiply the bottom by 8X. So we put an 8x over here as well. And now we can reduce. Okay, well the first one doesn't reduce, it's just multiply because there is no denominator. So that would give us 32x. Plus, that x will cancel and leave us with 16. All over, that 4 reduces and puts 2x. I like to cancel the whole thing, that way you can see it. It's just x. So we're left with 2x times x, that's 2x squared, and then 1 times x is x. Now before, these were not factorable, and we definitely can't cancel them. These are factorable, so we have to keep going. Top one has a common factor of 16. The bottom one has a common factor of x, and this is why we have to keep factoring. So we now have something we can cancel, and we're left with 16 over x, and that's the answer. All right, now it's your turn. Let's see if you can do this one. To get you started, I'll help you with the LCD. We have an xy, a y, and an x, so our LCD would definitely be xy. So when we multiply the top and the bottom, that's what we have to multiply by. Now the top is only going to get one xy. We don't have to write the one over here because there is no distributing. It's just the denominator we're focusing on. So hit pause, give it a shot. So you can go all the way to the end. All right, so if you don't have any mistakes, this is what you should have gotten. So on the top, the xy cancels completely. And on the bottom, I put another one for perspective right over here, just so I have something to cancel with, because we will distribute. canceled it, wrote it out, factored it, canceled again, and there's our answer. Alright, so what if you have three terms in there? Well, it's still the same exact thing. We put a parenthesis, we find our LCD, and all we have is an x on the bottom, and the largest exponent is x squared. So, when we write this, it's going to be x squared and x squared. And you're going to distribute it to all three terms. So, we're going to put one right here, and one right here, one right here, and one right there. That way we have something to cancel with. I'll do it in red this time. So this x will cancel one of those. Those two will take the entire thing away. Same thing here. This one takes away one of them. And there is our expression. So we have 2x squared minus 5x plus 12. And then on the bottom, 4x squared minus 4x minus 3. So see, all we're doing is putting the ones in green just because we know we're going to distribute, so we might as well distribute them anyways. It's just a quick step. All right, so now we can try to factor this. All right, so now we try to factor them. And this top one is not factorable because of the plus. See the plus 12 here. So we would have 3 and 4, 2 and 6, 1 and 12. And if you were to add any of these up, because they all have to be negative, which means we're actually adding them with the plus sign. Just looking at them right now, they all add up more than 5. So, top one's prime, can't factor, can't kill. That's our answer. All right, let's try the next one. All right, so on this one, we're going to do it a little differently, and it's because of this denominator. So our LCD here would be x minus 1, x plus 2. And so when we distribute it to the first one, x minus 1, don't write all this, by the way, because we're going to do it differently. If you notice, nothing cancels here, which means I'm going to have to FOIL this and multiply it to this, which is going to be massive. So whenever that's happening, you want to try going back to what we did originally. And that's to make it into one of our basic complex fractions, where it's a fraction on top, fraction on the bottom, not these multiple ones. So what we're going to do is add the top, add the bottom, and then rewrite it in that form. So let's add the top. Put a 1 into that one. And it's very obvious now that that's our common denominator. So the top one needs an x plus 2. And that gives us x plus 2 over x plus 2 minus 1 over x plus 2. And when we add them, we get x plus 1 over x plus 2. So that's what our top becomes, x plus 1 over x plus 2. Now the bottom, I'll do the bottom in green. Okay, so we have a 1 over 1 plus 2 over x minus 1, which is our common denominator. So the top would become x minus 1 over x minus 1, and then 2 over x minus 1. So when we add them, we get x plus 1 over x minus 1. And that's our denominator now. Put that one in a nice thick. So that's our division line right there. So when we divide these, we're basically going to flip the bottom, right? So it becomes x plus 1 over x plus 2 times this one flipped. So x minus 1 over x plus 1, which we can then cancel and create an answer of x minus 1, x plus 2. Now you could do this method for every single one of them. You could combine the top, combine the bottom, and then add them up. It would still work exactly the same, you know, flip them and everything. But to me, this method is easier for this type, and this method is easier for this type. That's why we want to use both of them. All right, thank you.